It's Sonny and Finn's Wrestling and Video Game Podcast. This week, we discuss Forza Horizon 3, our games of the year so far and what's still to come, and WWE Clash of Champions.
What's up, guys? Welcome to episode 32 of the Sonny and Finn Show. I'm Sonny, and with me, as always, Mr. 12,000, Finn Steele.
Hello.
How are you?
Very good, thank you. How are you?
I'm better this week.
Better?
Feeling better? Yeah, I feel better.
Good.
I feel like my body is a little bit knackered, though.
I'm not surprised.
Yesterday, I was like so tired. I had like a 4.5 hour sleep in the afternoon.
Nice. Yeah, that happens.
Yeah, it was crazy. Like, the medication that I'm on and like a combination of this, whatever I've had sort of leaving my system, is just sort of killing me off.
That's fair.
Like, if aliens were to come in and abduct me, they would send me back.
Yeah. The illness is a damaged subject. Yeah.
They would South Park anal probe me, and then they would send me back.
Nice.
You feeling good?
I've been fine, yeah. We're great.
Yeah? Good. You look very fresh today.
Thank you.
Is it because we're filming, and that's what you thought, well, I'll scrub up well?
Well, you know. No, just, you know, I showered.
You showered?
Yeah. Yeah.
Happy birthday.
Thank you. my monthly shower. That's a joke, I shower every day, people. Because, you know, every day. We're filming it this week.
We are filming it this week. I didn't know we were going to film it, so he's
just set up the camera.
So, yeah. He sprung it on me, and we've created a little bit of a set. We've got the Ultimate Warrior here with the Super Lucha's mask. We've got the Sonny and Finn Championship just behind Finn there, and
Super Lucha right now, whoever he is, jerk.
And of course, we have the most important features of the show, both Finn and myself.
Hello, this side. Hello.
Hi. We don't really do this very often.
Yeah.
At least not the video part anyway. We do the podcast every week. You wouldn't know it.
Do you even know?
But we do. But yeah, it's cool. Something gives you something to look at on YouTube instead of just looking at the podcast thumbnail, which is always very good.
Yes, thank you.
Before we start the show,
okay.
I just want to say thank you to anybody who turned up to our WWE 2K16 live stream this past Sunday for Clash of Champions.
Yes.
Lot of fun, as always. Great banter in the comments between everybody, so thank you very much for that. The next one is going to be No Mercy, which is a week from this Sunday.
Ooh.
And that's going to be our last on WWE 2K16.
Thank Christ.
Before, thankfully, we move on to WWE 2K17.
Yes. Woo, finally.
Yes.
It's happening. It's coming out.
Finally.
Yeah.
I feel like it's come around pretty quick, though. Like, from when it was first announced.
Yeah, that's true.
I think maybe it feels a little bit different for us because we play 2K16 all the time.
Yeah. It's normally we'd have stopped a long time ago by now.
Oh, yeah. I mean, that game would be rotting in my collection somewhere now, but...
Yeah, same.
For consistency's sake, we are still playing it.
Yeah.
But I can't wait for the new one.
Yeah. It looks great.
Yeah, it looks really good.
It looks great.
It's going to be horrendously out of date, and we're going to have to rely on community creations for a couple of months.
Yep.
Before we really have what we want.
Can't wait to play as the Matadors. It's my favourite tag team, current tag team.
Yeah. For those that don't know, we are the Sonny and Finn Show, and we are a weekly video game and wrestling podcast that posts every single Friday on iTunes, Stitcher, SoundCloud, YouTube, and anywhere else that you can find podcasts.
Everywhere.
Pretty much.
Except Google Play.
Except Google Play, except Spotify, except Amazon, I think they do podcasts now.
Oh, do they?
I don't know.
I'll have a look.
I don't think I don't know. I might not be in this country yet.
But probably not. We always seem to be the last people to get it.
Yeah.
So, but we'll see.
Yeah. We'll get it when podcasts are no longer, like, cool to do.
Yeah, exactly. Are they cool to do now? I don't know.
I don't know. I feel like we're late to the party.
Probably.
But that's not what we're all about. We're all about different things.
Yes, we're having fun.
We're having a lot of fun, and that
enjoying
is the main thing.
Exactly.
This week we're going to talk about our games of the year so far, what we've enjoyed playing, and what we're looking forward to coming up. We're going to run through Clash of Champions and talk about the usual wrestling stuff and some wrestling news. Also, let's start the show as we always do. What have you been playing?
I'm playing a lot of Forza Horizon 3, which came out this week.
Okay, yeah.
It's great.
It's superb, yeah.
Yeah, got a few minor niggles with it. I feel like sometimes it's purposely tried to take the fun out of things. Like, specifically, like, just little things. Like, why do I have to pay to fast travel to different festivals? why can I only fast travel to festivals? Why can't I just fast travel there? Why have to drive across the bloody country to get...
No, you're misunderstanding the point of the game. It's a fucking driving game.
I mean, yeah, clearly, but I'm on a race. I don't have to drive around for 10 minutes trying to get to where I'm trying to go.
I think maybe Forza Horizon isn't for you.
Maybe. But no, I don't know, arcadey open world games like Burnout and stuff before.
With Forza, that's like one of the main things of the game, driving to the new part of the festival and getting to see the gorgeous scenery.
Yeah, which is fine, but it's like...
Why do you want to fast travel?
Because it's faster. I've got things to do, games to play, backlog.
Stop playing Forza Horizon 3.
No, it's fun.
It's clearly not fun.
It's fun when I get to race and stuff. And then buy, like, cars... But I had to drive to the bloody place first. Why do I have to like pay to change my car? I've got the car. What? Don't really pay for it. Just give it to me.
But you're not in the garage. So someone's got to deliver it to you.
So?
Go to the garage and collect your car.
No. It's too far.
I'll just pay you 10,000 credits to do it.
Yeah, I can, but I don't want to. There's more money to spend. I'll save up for cars and junk.
You get more cars free than you need to buy.
Yeah, I guess
so. Like, I got a really good Audi for free, and this is what I've been driving around in, and it's awesome.
That's fair, but I never get anything with the bloody spin wheel thing. I get like 5,000 credits. It's like, cheers. That's all I ever get. Like, the lowest possible thing you can get.
I too have been playing Forza Horizon 3. And I think it's as close to perfection in a video game as you can get.
Okay.
It is. It's gorgeous.
I mean, it's a good game.
It plays like a dream. It's huge. You easily get your money's worth for it.
Yeah. It's huge, yeah.
It's truly a great achievement in racing gaming.
Yeah. I agree.
It's lost on you, clearly.
Is it just open world stuff? It's not.
But that's what it is. It's an open world racing game.
I know. But it's like, but just, I don't know. Don't make me travel so far. I don't know.
Stop playing Forza Horizon 3. What else have you been playing?
That's probably about it, really. That and more Tokyo Mirage Sessions. It's everyone knows and loves, clearly. On the Wii U, everyone's favorite console.
The Wii U gets a bad name. I think the Wii U is a great console.
Yeah, I do. I like it.
It's just on its last legs, but it's a great console.
Yeah, that needs to be announced and come out.
Yes.
Yeah.
And I think it will sooner rather than later. I mean, I don't know what Nintendo are even waiting for.
I know, yeah, right? It's like, every time they have an event, it's like, oh, they're going to announce the NX. Nope, here's some 3DS stuff. There's a new Color 3DS.
Yeah, and here's a Wii U game that's coming out that no one's going to buy.
Yeah, Paper Mario Color Splash.
Yeah, that is coming out, isn't it?
Yeah. I mean, I like Paper Mario, but it looks more like the 3DS game, which they made last time, which nobody liked.
Nintendo. They don't do things normally.
Just make the thousand year door again.
This is the game. Remake it.
Yeah, just bring it put on Wii U Virtual Console.
Did you say Game Gear?
GameCube.
Oh,
Game something.
GameCube.
Yeah. Game Gear Cube.
I would love a handheld that played GameCube games.
Yeah, me too. That'd be great.
I love that console.
Do it, Nintendo.
Do it, Nintendo. Do it for the ultimate lucha. He wants it.
I thought it was Super Lucha.
No, he's the Ultimate Lucha.
Oh, he is now.
That other guy is the Super Lucha.
Oh, I get it. Yeah, because of the... Yeah.
Oh, come on.
I'm slow.
That shower hasn't freshened you up at all.
It hasn't. I'm slow. It's a slow day.
I've been playing Forza Horizon and loving it.
Okay.
Don't listen to what this clown says.
I like it too. I'm not saying I like it. It's a
driving game and he doesn't want to drive.
No, it's not that. I like the driving in it. It's fun. It's a good game. I'm going to keep playing it. That's what you say.
Stop fast traveling. You're ruining it for yourself. Stop complaining about having to pay to have your cars delivered.
Why?
Like that wouldn't happen in real life.
What
do you expect to do? The fucking car to fall out of the sky?
Yes, it's a video game. It's not real life. It's not. This one isn't supposed to be like super sim realistic. That's what the Forza Motorsport's for. Keep that to Forza Motorsport. That's fine. Just give me the cars that I own.
I think you need to stick to these weird Japanese games.
Oh, that's fine. I'll gladly. Persona 5, please.
I've been playing Destiny. Just started the Rise of Iron stuff. It's great. I've only played sort of the first bit of Rise of Iron.
Good.
But still loving it. Still loving Destiny. I think it's superb. If I had one game that I could take to a desert island with me, it would be that.
Just think, play the same mission over and over again forever.
Well, no, I just create different characters and keep going and keep going and keep going.
Great.
I'm going to start a new character soon.
Okay. Why?
Because I love it. I love the game.
So I play. It's a good game. I liked it when it came out.
And I've been playing a lot of NBA 2K17, which, in my opinion, is the best sports sim around. I'm playing a heap of it, and I'm loving it. I think it's excellent.
Cool.
So there isn't a lot of gaming news this week, if any at all. So what we're going to do, we're going to jump straight into this week's topic, which is what are your favourite games of this year? Why? And what are you looking forward to? Finn, you can kick this off.
Okay.
What have you enjoyed this year? What have your favourite games been?
Well, the one I've played the most this year, easily, would be Overwatch. Multiplayer.
You don't say.
You don't, yeah. I miss it every week. But if you told me, like, at the start of the year that I'd, one of my favourite games this year would be, like, a multiplayer-only team-based shooter, I would have called it crazy. It's not the type of game I would normally play. But I don't know. There's something about Overwatch which is just special and magic, which I love. And, yeah, I'm loving it. It's great. One of my favourite games this year. Whether it'll be my favourite game this year remains to be seen. I don't know. But, yeah, other than that, Dark Souls 3. Excellent, excellent Dark Souls game. Possibly the best one yet. That or Bloodborne.
I'm actually re-downloading it to my console as we speak.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Nice. Nice.
I deleted it for space reasons and now, but obviously it just picks up your save because it's on the same console. So
awesome.
I'm going to get back into that.
Yeah, it's great. Looking forward to the DLC that's coming out soon, next month, I think.
Yeah. Yes. Well, next week, I think.
Is it?
Maybe. I'm not sure. I can't remember either way.
Oh, no, soon. To add to my backlog. Great. And yeah, other than that, Uncharted 4 as well, obviously, came out this year. It's wonderful. Quantum Break was okay this year, Xbox One.
Quantum Break was good, but the it would have been better, and I'm not knocking the TV episodes that are in between, but I feel like it would have benefited not having them there.
Yeah,
I think it would have attracted a wider audience.
Yeah, it's made the game slightly longer. Get rid of the crappy... I mean, they're not crappy, but they're...
No, they are good,
yeah,
and it, and it does help
things.
The story along, but I think it could have been done with just normal cutscenes. I mean, I'm sure that is what they wanted to avoid, and that's why they did opt to... Because obviously they had real actors in the game itself, so that's obviously why they've opted to have the TV series on there.
Yeah.
As you know, in between the game chapters, but I don't know, it was a bit long, and, you know, when... You just get into a really good part, the end of the chapter and stuff, and then it chucks you into a half an hour's worth of TV show, and you're like...
I don't have time for this.
You know, I just want to play the game.
Yeah, it's like...
But you don't want to skip the thing just in case you miss any of the story, so it's, it's a tough one.
It is tough. But yeah, it's a good game. The gameplay mechanics are really fun. And like,
yeah, time, the gameplay mechanics really cool.
Awesome. Yeah, that's about it, really. I still haven't played Doom. I really want to play Doom. Or Deus Ex. I played like 10 minutes of Deus Ex, but I just haven't gone back to it. But it's a shame, which is really, really good. But yeah, that's about it. How about you? What you've enjoyed this year?
I've got a few things, actually.
Okay.
Yeah, Firewatch came out this year, and I really loved it. I mean, I think it was more of an experience than a game.
Yeah.
But I think what was great about it, I loved the art style.
Yep.
I loved the voice acting was superb, and I loved the two characters.
Yeah, the characters were excellent. Very.
And I like that, really, you still don't fully know what it's about.
Yeah, it's a bit weird ending, but I don't know. I liked it as well.
They've just updated it, because it's just come out on Xbox One.
Oh, yeah.
And they've just updated the PlayStation 4 version for more trophies.
Oh, right, okay.
So there is some more trophies up for grabs now if you wanted to go back and play. It is only sort of like a, you know, a four-hour experience.
Yeah.
But I really enjoyed it. I think the story gripped me, and for that reason alone... And the two really enjoyable characters, that's why it's in my favourite games of this year so far.
Yeah, okay.
Ratchet and Clank is
nice.
In there.
I haven't played that either. We need to play that.
It's excellent. I haven't beat it yet, but just for what I've played alone, for a £30 game that was made basically to tie in with a movie that Sony was hoping was going to take off and set the world on fire, which it didn't.
Not really.
But the game itself is absolutely is brilliant. Insomniac have just done a wonderful job with that. And I hope that... I mean, I'm assuming it has been successful because it is really good. I'm hoping it spawns sequels.
Yeah.
And I'm sure it will. I'm sure that's going to happen.
Oh, yeah, for sure. No way. No, not going to...
Uncharted 4, obviously.
Of course.
My favourite game series ever. And it's come to an end now, and I'm disappointed with that. But the game was great.
Yep.
And I'll go back and revisit it at some point.
Nice.
This one I was unsure whether to include in it or not because I'm not still playing it, but I felt like I had to just because of the sheer amount of hours that I put in. The Division.
Ooh.
now, when The Division first came out, I was just absolutely in love with it. And I just I loved the because I love Destiny so much. So it's a similar sort of thing, obviously, yeah. Just in a different setting.
Yeah, I liked it as well when it came out.
And I put so many hours into it, and I loved doing the missions, and I loved gearing up and all that sort of stuff. But it's when the game ends, it's the end game from level 30 upwards that's just completely disappointing.
Yeah.
It's not been playable since. I've put it on twice recently and turned it off within 5 minutes both times. Just because it's not fun anymore. There is a patch coming out that's going to sort of change that and make it good again. Mm-hmm. So I'm waiting for that patch to come out. If it is good, I'll jump back in and carry on. If it's not, then it's going completely off my console.
Bad play. Yeah, it's a weird one.
Overwatch, I'm being into.
You're good.
I don't need to talk about it because you've talked about it enough for everybody.
So good. Cards are great.
One that you didn't like, but I did, Inside.
Ooh. Everybody loves that game. I don't get it. I hate it. It's so dumb.
It's technically...
I wasted 2 hours of my life.
Technically, Inside is just a brilliant game.
Technically, yes. Graphically, yes. Art style, yes. Gameplay, no, it's dumb.
No, the gameplay is really good. Like the gameplay itself is actually really good, and obviously everything in that game happens for a reason.
We just been writing push things.
Yeah, but it's not as simple as that.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't.
Okay.
But Inside was excellent, and you should go and play it. Just to experience it, just for the crazy ending and...
The ending was cool. The big thing at the end, I won't spoil it, was cool. The game was done.
The game wasn't dumb. I think it's really good. Critics are right and Sonny is right. Hashtag Sonny is correct.
Hashtag Sonny is dumb. Hashtag Finn is right.
Hashtag Finn doesn't want to fucking drive in a driving game and is a dipshit.
I thought of another thing I didn't like about Forza 3.
What?
I still like the game, disclaimer. It's a great game. I'm going to keep playing it. Play computer. Why do I have to unlock bloody the ability to play my own songs? I have to unlock like all the different radio stations before I can unlock my... Like song library? Why? I don't have to play for like 5 hours just to unlock my songs.
Picking faults with just a clearly incredible game.
On my soundtrack. My J-pop. I'm kidding. I'm not kidding about J-pop. I'm not kidding.
On the subject of J-pop, I put Hatsune Miku Project Diva X in my favourite games this year so far.
Correct.
Because it's excellent. It's a really good rhythm game. It's something that... I never thought I'd play, took me well out of my comfort zone as far as style and music is concerned, but overall I thought it's excellent and I'm still enjoying it now.
Good.
And I've put Forza Horizon 3 in there because, like I said before, it is as close to perfection in a video game as you are going to get.
It's a good game. Yes, I agree.
If you want to drive and want to listen to the very cool soundtrack that's been curated for the game that fits in perfectly with the style of the game.
The events are cool. The driver tower's cool, system's cool, even if they're too easy to beat.
Change the difficulty, that's what it's there for.
I did, I turned to expert, they can't beat me. It's like, once I get into first place, it's you first, you win. It's like, they're not going to overtake you again. I've noticed.
Don't play that game, sell it.
Maybe I'm just the best.
You're annoying me with that game.
I'm just the best Forza player in the world. I don't know.
You're not. You're the worst Forza player in the world.
That is mad.
Just sell the game. Sell the game and don't ever play it again. Delete it off your console.
No.
I'm going to delete you off my Xbox One.
No.
And I put NBA 2K17 in there as well.
Okay, good. That's fair.
What games are you looking forward to that you can pick apart?
Obviously, Final Fantasy 15. I love it already. I played the 2 demos of it and already love it. And it's great.
That game is fucked already.
Nope. You're wrong. Shut up. also Final Fantasy related. Well, the Final Fantasy. Looks adorable. Chibi art style, super cute. I love it.
That does look cool, actually.
Yeah, it's super cool. It's like Pokemon, but with Final Fantasy. Speaking of Pokemon, Pokemon Sun and Moon come out on the 3DS later this year. Pokemon's had a good year. Pokemon Go and whatnot.
Pokemon's gone through a renaissance this year.
Yeah, definitely.
It's made itself relevant again.
Yeah, easily. And yeah, looking forward to the new Pokemon games.
Yeah, and they'll be super popular as well. And I'm sure they'll be excellent. The last ones were really good. Ruby and Sapphire?
Yes, Omega Ruby and Alpha.
Yeah, that's right, isn't it? Yeah.
I think. Something like that.
That'll be excellent. Sun and Moon will be awesome.
Yeah. And also, the best game of the year ever to come out, Last Guardian. Going to get perfect scores everywhere. Obviously.
Mm-hmm.
As our bets, we have current outstanding bets. I have bet that Last Guardian will get above 80 in Metacritic. Sonny's bet below 80.
And I think I've got it nailed, to be honest.
Best game of the year. ever made.
I just think that game is in so much trouble.
Nope. Best game ever. Just like Final Fantasy 15.
I think Final Fantasy will be good, but I don't think it'd be better than just... I don't think it'd be any... It won't be worse than good. Like, it won't be... It will be good. It won't be any worse than that, but I don't think it's going to be much better than that. I don't think it's going to be sort of outstanding. I think the fact that the game has been being made for nearly probably as long as The Last Guardian. If not longer.
Yeah.
I don't know. There's problems with those two games that I just foresee trouble in their futures. They're going to sell. They're undoubtedly going to sell because of the hype behind both of them. I just don't think, like No Man's Sky, I don't think they're going to be the games that you're looking for.
Yeah. Funny that No Man's Sky wasn't on either of our best games of the year so far.
Yeah, surprising.
Yeah, I'll pattern that game. Still not that great. But yeah, no, Final Fantasy 15, the thing about Final Fantasy 15 is like, it's a different game now than it was when it was first announced. They've completely remade it from scratch, basically. And yeah, everything I've seen about the game looks amazing. It's going to be great. I think it'll review well, but there'll be some fan backlash because people are dicks. The other game I put on here is Mafia 3, which looks quite good, I thought.
Yeah, it's out next week as well. I'm excited for that one. Really excited for that one.
Mafia 2 was great.
Mafia 2 is really, really good. I hadn't played the first one either when I went into Mafia 1, because I think it was just a PC game.
I think so, yeah. Something like that.
You know, we don't do PC gaming. Well, I don't, at least.
I see.
So I hadn't played that one. I played Mafia 2 and it was excellent. So, and this one looks even better.
Yeah, that's great.
So I'm sure it's going to be brilliant.
Yeah. That's about it.
I've got a few different things on mine.
Okay.
Gears of War 4, which comes out early October. Same day as WWE 2K17, actually.
Oh, interesting.
Which is also on my list. Mm. But I'm interested in Gears because I've played the other... There's four in the series.
Yeah.
The three main ones and... The other one, I can't remember its name.
Gears of War, The Ascension, that's God of War.
Something Judgment. Like that, though.
Judgment.
Judgment, yeah.
Yeah.
So I played through all four of those, and I love the series, even though, you know, technically they are all basically the same.
Pretty much.
But I'm looking forward to this one, but this one also does look the same. But I'm sure the set pieces and the graphics are going to be great, so I'm looking forward to playing that one.
Who's it called, that on stream or something?
Yeah, for sure.
Definitely.
WWE 2K17, just because we've played 2K16 to death.
Oh, I didn't put that on my list. Of course, 2K17.
I look forward to it every year.
Yeah, it's great.
PlayStation VR.
Oh, yes, of course.
It's something that
I don't even think of that.
It's, to be honest, it's on my mind all the time at the minute, VR.
Yeah, same.
I'm just sort of like, oh, what's it going to... Because we've not tried it.
Yeah.
We've not had that luxury in this country, really. They've not demoed it a great deal.
Yeah.
We weren't at EGX, so we didn't get to see it there either. But it's something that I can't stop thinking about, and I'm so excited for, just to see what kind of experience we're going to have with it.
Yeah.
The games are going to be like.
Exactly. I want to film my reaction to it the first time I try it. Just so I want to have that on camera, maybe put on YouTube or something.
Yeah.
Just be like, whoa.
And we're going to stream us playing it as well. I've pre-ordered Batman VR and Until Dawn. So I'm just really excited. It's going to be a completely different experience, and I think it's going to change the way that we look at gaming. And for that alone, it's just so exciting.
Yeah. Every time I see someone in VR and they're reacting to it, I'm like, oh, I want to try it.
Yeah, I've heard nothing but positive things about it.
Yeah, same here.
I mean, I don't expect it to be 1080p, 60 frames per second crisp. I know that's not what it's going to be, but that's not what it's about.
No.
It's about being immersed in a world and in an experience, and I can't wait. I'm just so excited.
Yeah, it's going to be great.
It's just going to be so excited. Like you, I've got Mafia 3 on there.
Sweet.
Call of Duty Infinite Warfare. I wasn't excited for it.
Yeah.
But I've been playing Black Ops 3 recently, and I'm disappointed in myself that I didn't stick with it when I first bought it, because I'm really, really enjoying it.
Oh, good.
So I'm going to buy Infinite Warfare. I'm going to enjoy...
Of course you are.
Modern Warfare 4 Remastered. I'm going to play through that. The reason I'm going to buy it is it reminds me of winter gaming.
Yeah.
So, like, you come home from work or whatever, and it's freezing cold outside, and you're like, oh, now it's going to get warm, and I'm going to play Call of Duty.
Yeah, that's fair.
It's like something I buy. I say I'm not going to buy it every year, and then I buy it every year. It's like an inner war in myself that I'm losing.
You get sucked up in that hype tornado.
Sorry?
You get sucked up in that hype tornado.
I do, yeah. That tornado where I'm standing there looking at the idiots getting swept in, and then I just keep walking and keep walking and keep walking, and I'm sucked in.
Yeah.
And I've got Titanfall 2 as well.
Oh, yeah.
So cool. I'm looking forward to that.
Yeah, that'd be fun.
On the flip side of this, what have you been most disappointed with this year?
Ooh, good question. Forza Horizon 3, just kidding. Kidding. man, disappointed. No Man's Sky, obviously. Despite the fact that I platinumed it, just because I'm a platinum whore, I didn't like it. I did like it at first, but it got very repetitive very quickly.
Because I don't think it's a bad game. I just think it's not that the reason it's disappointing is because it isn't the game that was promised.
Yeah, kind of. Pretty much. It wasn't the game people were expecting, at least.
Anything else?
I'm trying to think. Disappointing games. I can't think of anything. How about you?
No Man's Sky is on there.
Mm-hmm.
The Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles game that came out.
Oh, yeah.
That was so disappointing. It looked really good. And like the trailers and everything made it look really good. And everyone was so excited for it. And then it came out and it was just like, well, this is just okay.
Yeah, that's fair.
It's not special. It isn't the Turtles game that I feel, given the strength of the franchise at the minute, I feel like we should be getting. And that's disappointing. It's okay. I mean, and that's all it is. It's just okay. And Mirror's Edge 2 as well.
Yeah.
I have not seen anybody talk about that game.
Yeah, it like came out. It's like got kind of okay reviews. Not great, but then it's kind of... Nobody went back to it again.
Because it seemed like loads of people were like really wanted it.
Yeah.
Like everyone loved the first one. It was short and everyone was like, oh, I really want more Mirror's Edge. When are we going to get more Mirror's Edge?
I really enjoyed the demo they released, but then just never ended up picking up the game.
Yeah, and then we got it and it was like, okay. Oh. I played the EA Access trial, which you get 10 hours of. And I didn't even bother playing through the 10 hours that I got because I was just like, this is just, this, I don't know, it's fine, I guess. But I don't know, the mechanics still feel kind of old, and the graphics are great. It looks like an EA game. It looks like an EA game using the DICE engine, it does. And it's just okay. Like the Turtles game, it's just okay. But the hype was non-existent seemingly for it. And I think my fear is this is the route that Titanfall 2 is going to go down.
Could be right, yeah.
Because they're sandwiching it in between... Battlefield, they're releasing the two together enough.
Same month.
So Battlefield and Titanfall come out real close to each other. Battlefield has got all of the hype. Titanfall has sort of got campaign hype and they're showing off multiplayer videos, but...
We have robots.
I think no EA Access trial is going to hurt it as well. I think.
Good point, yeah. That's a weird decision.
But,
very weird.
Yeah, I fear for Titanfall 2. I'm looking forward to it because I love the first one, but I fear for it. And especially with sort of the two biggest shooters of the year coming out around the same time as it, are people really going to stump up another £60 to play Titanfall when they've already got Call of Duty, which most people will probably pay over the odds for because they want Modern Warfare remastered.
Yeah.
Battlefield 1 as well. So be interested to see how that one plays out.
Yeah. I was thinking of the games that came out this year. One might be worth mentioning, Star Fox Zero. Had a lot of hype behind it on Wii U.
Mm.
Ended up kind of being not a great. Weird controls. Boring.
Yeah, I saw a lot of people sort of giving that one a hard time. Did you play it?
I didn't actually, but I've seen a lot of people playing it. And it just didn't look very interesting. It's kind of dull.
Yeah.
Like Star Fox 64 with all the fun taken out of it. And we're giving it weird controls, and here you go.
It's a strange one because Nintendo usually really looks after their franchises and doesn't tend to put out poor versions of them, which is a surprise to me. So, which is why I was expecting something maybe quite special from Star Fox. But like Mirror's Edge, no one talked about it when it came out.
Exactly.
Well, not at least not in a positive light.
No. Again, it got kind of medium okay reviews, but not great. Meh. Also, I'll probably put The Division on there just because. I didn't like it that much.
To be honest, it is in my games of the year, but Endgame onwards, yes, it is a very disappointing game.
Yeah.
I'm hoping they fix it with this patch. I really do, just because, I mean, I know I harp on about Destiny, like you go on about Overwatch, but Destiny is still fun to me. Like, and I feel like I've not been left behind, whereas The Division, you know, I took a few weeks out just because I played it to death, and then... jumped back in and felt instantly like I'd been left behind. Like that first DLC pack came out and I was like, well, I haven't got the gear for this.
Yeah.
Like, well, this is crazy. Like,
I have no chance against this.
Now the NPCs are like incredibly overpowered.
Yeah.
And that's what made me turn it off, and that's what they're going to fix. And we'll see. I mean, you'll hear me talk about it if they haven't fixed it, and if they have as well, because I'll heap praise on it. But it shouldn't have got to this point anyway. Destiny has gone from strength to strength, and Division just plummeted so quickly.
Yeah, seriously. Resident Evil Umbrella Corps. That's never going to be good in the first place, was it?
No, I don't think it was. No, I know. I don't think it was ever going to be good.
Yeah, that's about it, really. Star Ocean 5. Yeah, again, okay game, not great reviews. But yeah, other than that, that's about it. Oh, Metroid Prime Federation Force on 3DS. Yeah.
That just sounds stupid already.
It is stupid.
Like, when I heard that announced, I was like, no.
Yeah, exactly. You've got a new Metroid Prime. And it's the multiplayer 3DS weird thing. It's like, oh no, why? Why are you doing this?
Yeah, that's two franchises that Nintendo have sent out to die this year.
Yeah.
Which is a shame. I mean, I think with NX, I do think there'll be a new Metroid.
Oh, I really, really hope so. I really hope it's like a 2D game or something. Or the Metroid Prime, proper Metroid Prime.
The ones on the GameCube are great.
Oh yeah, they're amazing. I love them.
Something like that. But Nintendo need to do something to resurrect that franchise. But they need to do it. They need to, you know, don't just rush it out for the sake of the NX launch.
Yeah.
Take your time with it and, you know, let it be the game that it should be.
Yes, agreed.
Like Zelda, they're giving it all the time in the world. It was him. It looks fantastic, and I'm sure it will be fantastic. When's that? Is that next year?
It's next year.
Early 2017, isn't it?
Yeah, it was going to be this year, but it got pushed back.
Yeah, I mean, Of course, yeah. I don't think we'll see it early next year either.
Probably not.
I don't think we'll see it launching with the NX.
Yeah, I'd say.
That said, we don't know when the NX is launching. I saw a leak earlier on today. I don't know if you saw the same one.
Oh, yeah.
There was like, it's going to be more expensive than the PS4 when the PS4 launched, and it's coming December 31st this year.
That's a weird leak. I think that sounds more like a placeholder date than anything else. That was true.
Would you really bring a console out on New Year's Eve?
No, of course not.
No, that'd be stupid.
That's dumb.
So we'll assume that is untrue, and we're not going to report on anything else NX until we've got something concrete, because we have talked about it and we're no closer to anything. So
yeah,
we're having an NX ban on the Sonny and Finn show, we had a Arkham Origin, no, Batman Arkham Return to Arkham ban.
That's the one.
Yeah, because I was so excited for it, and it shattered my dreams. I should have had that game and completed it by now.
Yeah.
But I still don't have it, and it comes out in like 3 or 4 weeks' time.
Yeah. Yeah, it's mountain time.
Yeah.
I think, yeah.
Yeah. Warner Brothers, yeah. I'm hoping they're going to send me a copy of it for my waiting.
That'd be nice. But yeah, no more NX stuff until we get some actual news.
Yeah. When we get actual news, we'll go all out on it.
Yeah.
But until then, nothing else.
Indeed. So, is that it for gaming stuff?
I think so. I enjoyed that.
Yeah, that's good.
I hope there's no gaming news more often so that we can sort of jump into a topic that we can talk about.
Yeah, we're good.
Yeah.
It's been slow news weeks for the past few weeks. And
it has, yeah. There is some good games coming out, which is good for us.
Yep.
Looking at the games list that we've had, I mean, there's loads of games come out this year, but the games that we've picked are very different.
Yeah, that's true.
I think that's good. I think it's good that we both have different tastes. If we both sat here and harped on about the same games, I think it'd just be the most boring podcast of all time. Maybe people think it is anyway, but...
No, we're the best podcast of all time.
Agreed. Let's talk about that Toy Odyssey video that's blown up. Like, how many were we on this time last week?
I can't remember. Like 5,000, 6,000, something like that?
Were we even on that many this time last week?
Probably not.
Because I'm pretty sure we were sitting here at one point and we were like, man, it's got 400 views. It's killing it.
Yeah, what's
and then, like, the next day we looked and it was like, Finn, this video has had like 6,000 views.
Yeah, crazy.
And now, like, so it was like 12,500. It's like, what?
Yeah. It's through no fault of my own. It's basically someone linked it on their website and got a bunch of views from there.
And, do this more often with our stuff.
Yeah, please. More links, please. Is that Tony coming at 12,929 views?
Jesus.
34 likes. Thanks. So at least people are liking it. That's the main thing.
Yeah.
I'm more interested in the 34 likes than I am the views, honestly. Because it means we're doing a good job, at least.
It does.
People like us, seemingly.
Yeah, and we've got a good little community of people as well. But it's nice that, you know, nearly 13,000 people have stopped by our YouTube channel to watch it. Finn play a random game that we were sent by a developer after not really knowing what the game actually was.
Yeah. And I reviewed it, which you can check out our video on YouTube now. Go with 3 stars. It's good. Kind of. It's good, but with problems.
Sure.
Yeah.
And there's a review of PES 2017 coming.
Yes. It'll be out this end of this week.
I finished the script. And Finn's going to edit it all together and put it out there.
Yep. It's going to be good.
So, let's move on to the wrestling segment of our podcast.
Yes.
Clash of Champions was this past Sunday.
It was.
What did you think to the show?
It was a good night wrestling. Weird results. Not much really happened. Nothing really changed.
No. I mean, only one title changed hands.
Did it? Oh, yeah, it did. Yeah, it was the US title, of course.
Just going to bring it up on here.
Yeah, so there's that at least, but that means that feud's going to continue, which is like, more Rusev versus Reigns, good, great.
Yeah, I mean, it was a good show. I mean, when I was watching it, I wasn't bored, and I thought the wrestling and the action I thought was really good.
Yeah.
Terrible crowd, awful crowd.
Yep, terrible crowd, same as before.
So, yeah, awful crowds. If you're going to go to a WWE event, at least go to enjoy yourselves. Don't just go sit there and talk amongst yourselves and act like dicks and chant for people. Yeah, chant for people who aren't even there and are never coming back. It's just, it baffles me. And I don't know, I'm beyond the point of bored of it now.
Yeah.
I mean, I was bored of the CM Punk chants as soon as he left.
Yeah.
And the fact that it's still going now and it's clearly just...
There's no need for it.
It's marks, isn't it? That's exactly what it is.
It's just, yeah.
People acting stupid for the sake of acting stupid, and it's not clever, it's just really annoying.
Yep. Annoying to fans, annoying to the wrestlers, just annoying.
What we could do here is, because Raw didn't really give us anything substantial this week.
Yeah, seriously.
So I thought we could sort of talk about Night of Champions, Clash of Champions, and sort of integrate what happened with these feuds on Raw the next night.
Okay.
Do it that way. Nia Jax defeated Alicia Fox on the pre-show.
Yep.
Unsurprisingly, Alicia Fox did give, Nia some kind of fight.
She got more offensive than I thought she would.
But Nia won. Yeah, the match went nearly 5 minutes, and that's much longer than I thought it would.
Yeah, same. But yeah, it was fine.
Neither appeared on Raw the night after. They did mention it, but nothing really happened. Nia wasn't on Raw.
No.
I don't know what's going on with Nia at the minute. I don't know where she is. I know we say this seemingly every week, but I don't know where she is in terms of what's your place in the women's division right now.
Yeah, where do you go from here? I'm sure eventually she'll still be going for the title and probably win it. But yeah, right now they're kind of feuded like Charlotte and Shasta still. It's like, what's happening? What's happening there? We don't know.
Yeah.
Did they just insert Nia into that, or did they wait until that's over and then Nia came in?
What they need to do is they need to find a way to integrate her. I mean, if she's going to keep running rule over the women's division and, squashing people who are kind of established, then, once this Sasha and Charlotte thing are sort of passed, maybe she can interrupt Charlotte in one of her... But the problem is... I feel like a face needs to have that championship for Nia to go for the championship.
Yeah, that's a good point.
It's a weird one, and one that I don't see coming, being played out anytime soon.
Yeah, you're probably right.
New Day. They beat the Club.
They did.
Now,
where's shenanigans?
The New Day are faces. Super over, super faces.
Mm-hmm. For now.
They've had the tag team championships for, now over 400 days.
Mm-hmm.
We both predicted that the Club were going to win this.
Yep.
And for me, the Club needed to win this.
Agreed. It looked like they were going to win it at some point, especially at the start when they attacked Big E on the outside and Xavier Woods on the outside. And the massive power one was like, it's going to be it. It's going to win straight away.
Yeah, that's what I thought as well. I thought this is going to be a quick one.
Yeah, but no. Wasn't meant to be, apparently.
And they won by Xavier Woods hitting Luke Gallows with Francesca.
Yeah.
Francesca 2, and
which one,
pinfall was scored in the ring, and I instantly just shook my head when the three count hit, and I was just thinking, man, this is killing the club so quickly.
Yeah. Also, might then do the New Day any favors. I think the crowd's going to turn on New Day soon. That's going to be my prediction. Because, like, they're funny, they're very entertaining, very charismatic guys, but it's kind of the same thing every week, and it's like, it's been 400 days now. It's kind of getting stale, maybe.
Yeah, it's going to get to that point where people are going to want to see a new champion. And the longer that it keeps sort of not happening, like, I think people do genuinely want to see the club win the titles.
Yeah.
And when they, you know, if they were to ever do that, I'm sure the crowd would absolutely love it.
Mm.
But at the minute, people, I don't think they really know how to react.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, New Day have won. We should cheer because we've cheered for their entrance and gone through all their shtick with them. But we want the club to win because we like Gallows and Anderson. it's hard. But I'm at a point now where New Day can be over with or without the championships.
Yeah.
It's like Enzo and Cass. But the club are in a point where they now need those championships to solidify themselves.
I think the titles are hurting the New Day more than it's helping them at the minute.
Yeah, I completely agree with that.
Yeah, they don't need it.
What doesn't help is that they had a rematch on Raw the night after.
Yeah.
And once again,
I really thought they were going to win. This big move, like Boom Doom or whatever it was. Magic Killer, that's the one. In the middle of the ring, no one seemed to be around. And then Kofi just came in. They broke it up.
Yeah.
Blood dripping down his face.
So the question is, he got busted open big time.
Yeah.
But the problem is now, is what is next for the club?
Hmm.
Because, you know, they didn't win at Clash of Champions. Keep saying Night of Champions. Force of habit, I'm sorry. Clash of Champions. They didn't win in the rematch on Raw. What now? That's two chances they've had at the... I mean, probably more than that, actually. They lost at SummerSlam.
Mm-hmm.
They lost at Clash of Champions. And they lost again on Raw. That's three chances they've had at the championships.
Yeah. And now it's like, Sheamus and Cesaro's going to go for it next. So
it's like the club just aren't realistic contenders anymore.
They're not really.
And that hurts them big time.
Yes. It's a weird place.
For me, what needs to happen with the club now is they need to go on some sort of complete rampage. Like, start destroying tag teams.
Yeah.
And stake your claim for those titles for whoever is going to hold them next.
Agreed.
Because...
make everybody. Interrupt the match between Sheamus and... whoever, Cesaro and the New Day. Just haven't beaten them up all up, look dominant, haven't standing tall.
Yeah. That's what needs to happen. Whether that happens or not remains to be seen, but these recent matches have hurt the club, and I think they've hurt the New Day as well.
Yeah, I agree.
Yeah. TJ Perkins beat Brian Kendrick in his first Cruiserweight Championship.
Yep. I love TJ Perkins' entrance.
Yeah, I was going to ask you about that.
It's
cool. You like it?
Yeah, I love it.
Great. I think it's pretty cool.
Yeah.
I was talking to a friend of mine, and he wasn't sure about it.
Okay.
He thinks the entrance is fun, but he doesn't think TJ Perkins comes across as a fun person.
Right, okay.
Which is interesting. Oh, but I like it. I like the music. I was shocked by it, to be honest. I was expecting it to just come out to the music he came out at the CWC, but I like it. It's fun. It's, you know, video gamey, so it sort of appeals to us.
Yeah.
But I like it. It's cool.
Yeah.
And I like TJP. I can see what WWE are trying to do with him.
Yeah.
You know, he has the potential to be a big time player in WWE.
Yeah, definitely.
Like, he's got it all. He's not a bad looking guy. He's got, you know, a very flashy moveset. He does his dancing and the dab and stuff like that on his entrance. And, you know, he's got a cool entrance and all that sort of stuff too.
Yep.
I just wish the crowd were more into it. I don't know what it is.
Yeah, I think it's just people who didn't watch CWC. It's like, oh, it's like, who are these people? Why should we care? That's John CM Punk's name.
It's
weird. Even though the match was excellent, I thought. One of the best matches of the night.
I don't think the crowd were lost so much on the match at night at Clash of Champions.
Oh, yeah, Jason. Raw one thing.
I think it was the Raw one that was, more of a disappointment as far as the crowd is concerned.
Yeah.
But the match between Kendrick and TJ Perkins was great. I love the story that they're telling with Brian Kendrick.
Yeah.
Now he's you know, he's the big heel of the cruiserweight division.
Yep, yep.
And I called exactly what was going to happen.
Yep, Kendrick, I think wrote in my notes, Tony called it. Kendrick went to shake his hands, gave him a hug, then headbutt him in the face.
Yep. TJ Perkins retains. We both had that.
Yep. Oh, we didn't talk about our predictions. So, Zach Spless is not Zach Spless, Lisa Fox. We both said Nia would win, obviously. Neither of us said both said Club would win. Both wrong. And this, we were both right. We both said Tuesday P. So it's 2-2. There we go.
Cool. And they had a match. There was a match on Raw the next night, which was TJP versus Drew Gulak.
Yes.
Who I really like. Yep. No, I'm wrong.
Nope.
Fought Tony Nese.
That's the one. Tony Nese. Drew Gulak was on earlier night.
Yes. TJ Perkins went up against Tony Nese, who has a very similar look to Neville.
Yeah.
Corey Graves even said that in the comms as well. But the crowd was so disrespectful during the match that they had on Raw, which is a real shame because, you know, these guys, they can only go out there and, you know, do what they do. The match wasn't boring.
Good match.
Two very different styles. Tony Nese is quite a power cruiserweight, you know, but he, you know, combines it with the flying. TJP is, you know, very high flying and technical.
Yep.
The crowd, it's not these guys' fault that you didn't watch the CWC.
Exactly, yes. Just shut up, sit down, shut up, enjoy the match.
Yeah. Don't chant CM Punk because, one, it's just completely fucking disrespectful to the guys that are working in the ring.
Yeah.
And two, CM Punk is never coming back and he's a complete fucking douchebag.
Yeah, he didn't even watch it, so he's not going to know you chanted it.
You're cheering for a guy who is 0-1 in UFC.
Yeah, he lost in like 2 minutes.
Yeah. Like, just cut that crap out.
Yeah, just, I know you don't know who they are yet. If you watch the match and pay attention, then you'd know who they are and you can cheer for them.
These are the same fans that are crying for new stars to be built.
Yeah.
Yet they're booing and chanting for CM Punk and Randy Savage during their match. It's completely mind-blowing to me. And yeah, you're right. It's completely dumb. But the Cruiserweight division, I think is looking very strong. There was a good tag team match earlier on in the night with Rich Swann and Cedric Alexander, two of my favourites, against Drew Gulak and Lindsay Dorado.
Yep.
Who I'm super happy for.
Yeah.
I think Drew Gulak is really, really good. Lindsay Dorado the same.
Yep.
Cedric is getting incredible amounts of TV time right now.
Yeah.
He was on NXT last week and Raw, and he's on Raw again this week, and I think they've got big plans for him.
Yeah. Yeah, he's great. Love seeing him. Still no Noam Dar, though. Weird.
He's just finished up his indie days.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. So I think we'll see him fairly soon.
Yeah.
He was still, as of last weekend, or the weekend just gone, still sort of finishing indie days in Scotland. So
that's fair.
I think we'll see him soon.
Cool. Okay, didn't know that. That's good. Good to know. Because he was heavily advertised beforehand. It's like here's Cruiserweights, and he's not there. He's like,
I think the purpose of sort of having these tag team matches is to introduce the Cruiserweights sort of slowly.
Yeah.
And I think we may even see sort of Noam Dar in a tag team match maybe next week or the week after.
Yeah.
Sooner rather than later, I think, anyway.
Yeah, I think you're right.
There's a wealth of talent. They just need to be given a chance by the, I don't like to say casuals, but casuals who did not watch the CWC and those that don't watch NXT because these guys have been sort of featured on both of those programs.
Yeah, that's true.
Give them a chance.
Yes, please do.
Cesaro versus Sheamus in the Best of Seven series. Match 7 was at Clash of Champions.
Yep, yep.
What did you think to the match, and what did you think to the outcome of the match?
I thought it was a very good match. Lots of big, crazy moves. Cesaro did a very slow looking 619, which is weird and cool.
Yeah.
The crazy dive on the outside, landing right in his neck. Ugh, how are you alive, Sheamus? Cesaro. Craziness. Luckily, he's fine. The ending, they're both on the outside. I think Cesaro clothesline Sheamus over the barricade. And at this point, the WWE network crashed, and I didn't see the ending, but I assume it's like a double countout or something.
No.
It was called off, wasn't it?
It was called off.
Yeah. Because they're both injured.
Yeah. The match started really slow, and I was worried for the match at this point because it seemed to suck a bit of life out of the crowd. And I was like, oh, no, because this has been such a strong series. It needs to have a strong ending.
Yeah, definitely.
The match did pick up, and it was great. Cesaro took that nasty bump after the suicide dive, which was just
Let's say 27 replays. No.
What I liked is that you could see as soon as Cesaro hit his head, Sheamus tried to protect him straight away.
Yeah, yeah.
Like by sort of wrapping his arms around his head to try and make sure he's okay, which I liked, which was nice to see.
Yeah, good to see that.
Got to protect each other.
Yeah.
The match ending, I thought was... I didn't enjoy it. I wanted an ending.
Yeah, same. I wanted there to be... Oh, the camera's gone off. I wanted there to be an actual winner. I wanted to have an actual championship match for one of these guys. For like an actual, like, you know, main event push.
Yeah.
But yeah, we never really got that. But...
It was disappointing how sort of... Because Cesaro seemed like he was ready to go again in the match. Mm. But they sort of took four people to walk Sheamus backstage, and that was that's how the match ended, basically. But Raw, it felt like a typical WWE way to deal with it.
Yeah, pretty much.
It's like, right, it's a draw. We're just going to call it a draw, and we're going to put you in a tag team because... we don't know what else to do with you.
Yeah, exactly.
So, okay, so now both of them have been put in a tag team championship match against the New Day. And I am 100% certain that they're going to win the titles.
Yeah, it makes sense. Otherwise, what's the point of having a tag team in the first place?
WWE have a history of this. Oh, let's put two guys that don't like each other in a tag team and have them win the titles.
Yeah.
Shawn Michaels and Stone Cold. Dude Love and Stone Cold. Stone Cold and Triple H. The Rock and Mankind. Kane and Daniel Bryan. You know, the list goes on, and it's just... It's a trend that needs to be broken, because I hate it when that happens. Tag teams are there to win the tag team titles.
Yeah.
Not guys who are singles competitors and singles specialists. That's not what the tag team division's about.
Exactly. But it's like it takes attention away from the actual tag team wrestlers.
Yeah. Because Cesaro and Sheamus, they aren't tag team specialists. They're just Cesaro and Sheamus.
Exactly.
I don't know. I do see them winning it, which is disappointing. As long as the club comes out the eventual winners of this situation,
I hope so.
I'd be happy, but I don't know if that's what's going to happen at this point.
Yeah. I'll say.
So because that one sort of played out to a no contest, neither of us get a point.
Yep. Still to all.
Then we move on to Chris Jericho versus Sami Zayn. Now, this was a sort of a nothing match going into this anyway.
Yeah, pretty much. A little feud.
The match was fine. I thought it was a good wrestling match.
Yeah.
The ending and the outcome really confused me, because Jericho won.
He did.
Which neither of us had. We both went for Sami Zayn. So nil pois for either of us. But Sami really needed the win.
Yeah, that's true. He did.
Because Sami's in no man's land at the minute. Jericho is super over no matter what he does. Win, lose or draw, Jericho is over, and that is the be all, that is the long and short of it. Like, Jericho is just massively over. You know, with the list of Jericho stuff and the It's catchphrase and his sort of friendship with Kevin Owens, Jericho could not wrestle again and he'd still be super over. He just needed to talk every week.
Yeah, pretty much.
So it was strange to me that Jericho won. What do you think?
But it was my note said, okay, match, nothing special. Jericho won, which is weird. We couldn't sum it up my thoughts on it.
Yeah.
It was a good match, but it wasn't amazing. Weird outcome.
Very weird outcome.
We like Jericho, don't get me wrong. And, you know, then again, seeing him win, but...
Yeah, of course.
Sammy needed it more, I think.
Yeah, Sammy absolutely needed it more. And Sammy wasn't even on Raw the night after either.
He wasn't, yeah.
So it's, you know, where is Sammy at the minute? What sort of situation is he in? Maybe a move to SmackDown would benefit him.
Maybe.
Maybe it's too soon into the brand split for those sort of trades to happen, but maybe. I can't help but think that it would benefit him at this point, perhaps.
Yeah, Jack Swagger went.
Exactly. I mean, his contract was expired. The shortest contract of all time.
Yeah, worst sort of contract.
But Jericho was on Raw the night after, sort of doing his usual stick, like nothing had ever happened, like the match didn't even happen.
Yeah, I think he missed it, didn't he?
It was, you may as well have had that match on the pre-show or not at all, for the fact that it just didn't enhance Jericho in any way, nor did I expect it to.
Yeah.
And Sammy didn't win, so what's the point?
Exactly. Weird one.
Yeah. The Women's Championship match, triple threat, Charlotte, Bayley, and Sasha Banks. Mm. Three women who know each other very well.
Yep.
And put on another really great match.
Yeah, it's a great match. Possibly the match of the night. Yeah, it's wonderful. There's no DQ. So obviously, Dana got involved quite a bit. Maybe think why didn't they just team up and double team everyone, but whatever. Wrestling.
Yeah, not, wrestling. Not this thing. Just wrestling logic.
Yeah. At one point, Charlotte did a really nice looking moonsault onto Bayley and Sasha.
Mm.
Best moonsault in the business.
She's she's a crazy athlete.
Yeah, she's crazy good. I like her a lot.
Yeah, I've got a lot of time for Charlotte at the minute. I think she's doing really good work. This time with the belt is how they should have done it the first time when she had the belt.
Yeah. Agreed.
Yeah, no Ric Flair. And she's a super heel. She's just incredible. Like,
yeah.
She knows how to work the crowd as a heel, and she knows how to talk in character as a heel, and she just knows how to work it perfectly. And I think she's one of the top heels in WWE at the minute, especially on Raw.
Yeah, agreed.
She's one of, if not the top heel.
Yeah, definitely agreed. Do you think it might have gone on, could have gone a bit, maybe a little longer. Charlotte won with the kick, big kick to Bayley.
Yeah,
which is a bit weird.
When it ended, I was like, they're ending it like that.
Yeah, but I don't know. Big boot, it's a fine move. It's got the legs to back it up, sure.
Yeah.
So why not? Yeah, good match. I liked it.
Yeah, I liked it a lot. I have to be honest, I was surprised that Charlotte won, but I'm not mad that she did because, you know, part of me wanted to see Bayley win and Sasha turn on her the night after, like I, you know, said would happen.
Yeah.
I thought that would have been the better way to go as opposed to having Sasha winning it straight back, because it would have looked like they were just sort of giving it back to Sasha after her little injury break.
Yeah, that's true, I guess.
The night after on Raw, obviously they're going to carry on Charlotte and Sasha. Bayley had a squash match against Anna Fields.
Something like that. I've got it down somewhere. Yeah, Anna Fields.
Okay. So, you know, Bayley was in a squash match just to enhance her after her loss at Clash of Champions, God Almighty, which is fine.
Yeah.
But Charlotte, again, with some brilliant promo work on Raw, undermining Dana. That Dana split is coming soon.
Yeah.
I'm certain of it. And they're gonna really push Dana, I think.
I think so.
But I'm not mad at... it's just fine. I'm not mad at Sasha versus Charlotte. But they can't do it forever.
Yeah.
Eventually, there's going to have to be another challenger.
Yeah. So
you either have to take the title from Charlotte, put it on Sasha, then have Sasha take on Nia Jax. I don't know. I really don't know. Part of me wants Charlotte to have a real monster run with the championship again.
Yeah, yeah. That'd be cool. Yeah, I can't see Sasha winning it next week. I think they're having a match next week, aren't they?
Oh, yes, they are, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. So I can't see her winning it yet. But then I'm not sure what happens after that, because who else is there on Raw? Other than maybe Nia Jax, but that'd be heel versus heel, so that'd be weird. Maybe Dana.
See, the way I could see it panning out next week is Dana costing Charlotte the title and Sasha winning it back.
Yeah, could be that. Could happen.
We'll see. It's an up in the air one.
It is. One of those ones that's tough to call, because it's like it's too many elements, and it's like the end of one feud, and there should be a new feud starting soon, so it's like we don't know what's going to happen.
Yeah. Next week could be quite interesting.
It could be.
As far as the women's division is concerned.
Yeah.
But I really like the place that the women's division's in at the minute, because I'm actually excited for the matches.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm excited for that match next week. I have no doubts that it's going to be amazing.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know how it's going to play out, obviously, like we've just said, but it's going to be very interesting to see.
Yeah, for sure.
So, this takes us on to the United States Championship match.
It does.
Roman Reigns versus Rusev.
Mm-hmm.
Roman wins the United States Championship.
Hooray. Was I called? Yay.
It was actually a good match, I thought.
It was right, yeah. Roman powered out of the accolade. which is making me look strong.
Which drew incredible amounts of boos from the crowd.
Yeah, that's a bit weird, but fine, whatever. Lana got thrown out of the match after she pulled off the referee. Lucky ref. yeah, Roman won with a big spear, which Michael Cole called the next night on Raw one of the most devastating spears I've ever seen. It's like, what was it?
Yeah, it looks like every other spear ever.
It's been normal spear to me.
Yeah.
It's fine. It's fine. Nothing against Roman Reigns being US champ. It's cool. It's fine. Whatever.
The problem...
So like, what is the matches like? I don't really care either way. I'm bothered.
Yeah, I mean...
It's not really that interesting.
Except I said Rusev was going to win, didn't I?
You did. You got a point.
I also said Bayley was going to win, and you said Sasha was going to win. We're not doing very well with these predictions on this pay-per-view.
We're not. 3-2 at the minute.
To me. You?
To me, yes. Yeah, me.
Yeah, you. I've got nothing against Roman Reigns being the champion. Obviously, we're going to get another match out of this.
Yeah, for sure. Get to no one.
Which sucks, but hey, it is what it is. Roman is too big a star at this point to not be doing anything substantial.
Yeah, that's true.
Despite the punishments. it is what it is. Roman Reigns is the United States champion. We're going to have to deal with it.
Yeah.
I don't want this feud to drag out any longer than it really has to, though. There needs to be another challenger.
Yeah, I agree with that.
Well, Sammy would have been perfect. Sammy needed to beat Jericho, then go for the United States title.
Yeah, that'd be great.
Roman's a super heel anyway.
Maybe Neville. Neville's not doing anything.
Where's he been?
I don't know. Not on Raw.
How much does he weigh? Get him in the cruiserweight division.
Yeah. Maybe get Tony Nese. That'd be a good match.
Yes, that would be an awesome match.
Yeah.
That's what I want to see. Tony Nese versus Neville.
Yeah, same. US title.
The mini muscle men.
Yeah.
Versus each other. Flipping and flopping around.
Flipping flopping.
Yeah.
Episode title. Got it.
But yeah, I mean, that match was what it was, and Roman's the champion, and that's it.
Yeah. It's fine. It's fine.
This carried on Raw, I think.
I think he said some stuff, and then, yeah. I think they had a match, didn't they? Someone had a match with someone. Just trying to find it in my notes. A bit slurp, no, police and stuff. Roman Reigns and Rusev. They had a rematch. That was it.
For the title?
Yes. It's pretty much copy-paste from the match they had on Clash of Champions. And it ended up in double count-out. They both made it into the crowd.
I remember. So that's just basically a cop-out so they can have that match again.
Yeah, definitely. Rusev grabbed the chair just to remind everyone that he's a heel. And then Roman got up a hand because, of course, he did. And the rivalry continues.
Yeah, and then Roman walloped Rusev with that chair, didn't he?
Did he? No, he just kind of sat down on it.
He did sit down. Yeah. No, he did hit him eventually.
Did he?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Fair enough. One of the ones paying attention, did he?
Yeah, I think he did. I'm sure he did. I don't even know anymore.
Don't even remember.
We spent way too much time talking about this crap match.
We have.
That feud will hopefully culminate at Hell in a Cell.
You better.
Kevin Owens versus Seth Rollins. What did you think to it?
Good match. Yeah, good match. What else to say? Weird way to end it again with Chris Jericho and all that. Referee went down for like 10 hours.
Yeah, too much interference. I thought the match dragged a little bit.
Man, that'd be a little bit. I like the gutbuster onto the... No, yeah, the gutbuster off the top rope was critical. I like the attempted sent onto a table with like the socket chant. After that, it all kind of went downhill. Because Jericho got there, came down. Referee got knocked down. And stuff happened.
Yeah, there was too much going on. I think I sort of lost interest halfway through the match, especially when sort of the interference started happening, and then the ref took the softest bump of all time.
Yeah,
refs are wimps.
They are. They replayed on Raw in like slow motion. Like, look at this bump. It's like he didn't touch him like at all.
Yeah,
like grabbed his arm.
It's terrible.
He's like, oh, I'm down. Oh.
So I mean, that sort of ruined. No Triple H still. Obviously, I mean they had the interview with Steph after or whatever.
Whatever.
But it was just okay for me. I sort of lost interest. I knew Kevin Owens was going to win.
Yeah, of course it was.
But the interference and the crappy ref bump ruined it a little bit for me.
Yeah. It was cool looking pop a powerbomb counter into the pedigree, which I kind of liked.
Yeah.
I threw him up and he like landed on his neck and like into pedigree position. That was cool. But yeah, It's a good match, ruined by interference stuff.
Yeah, and I think that's what took the crowd out of it as well. So the sort of crowd were just, the life was sucked out of them when the nonsense started happening. It didn't need to happen. They could have just had a really good match, but of course, the way that the story's been playing out and all this, you know, it needed, it I don't know, it's stupid. It's WWE.
Yeah, WWE. What can you do?
Yeah.
Yeah, both said Owens would win to break it a point. Yep. But final scores are me with 4 and Sonny with 3, which means I get another point. I'm catching up.
You are catching up.
Scores are now 9-8 overall bets. All I need now is the semi HD collection to get announced, and I'm back in contention.
The extra pay per views are helping you out.
They are, yeah. Just
big time.
Give me a boost.
They are giving you a big boost.
Yeah.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Let's move on to SmackDown.
Yeah, okay.
So just going back actually to Kevin Owens and Seth Rollins. This obviously is going to happen again. Seth wasn't cleared to wrestle on Raw. And,
he came down during the main event, didn't he? He was like,
yeah,
I'm here, and he got dragged off by
the random main event of Enzo and Cass, who they clearly have no idea what to do anything with.
Yeah. Oh yeah, these guys exist. Let's put them in a match.
Yeah, and they lost again clean. Yeah. So I don't know what's going on with that at the minute.
What's about down there? During Charlotte's promo, Charlotte called Sasha Wanks.
Oh, she did, yes.
It's like, okay, sure.
Sasha Wanks. That's what an interesting thing to say.
Yeah, I think it's going for the wah, crying thing. But Sasha Wanks, yeah. That is now a thing. Do with it what you will, internet.
Can we please have that in our podcast this week? Our podcast name.
Well, we're going to call it Sasha Wanks?
Yeah.
All right.
Flipping and flopping with Sasha Wanks.
Yeah, that'll be in the description somewhere for sure. I'll try to make a thumbnail of that. That'd be an interesting one.
Yeah, okay.
Rated X thumbnail.
Sasha Wanks.
Dear.
Yeah, so Kevin Owens and Seth Rollins will happen again, probably at Hell in a Cell. So Raw was basically a nothing show again this week. It was fine.
Yeah, it's basically Clash of Champions again.
Yeah.
Again.
Why watch that pay-per-view?
Yeah, why bother?
I mean, and it did a horrible rating this week, but I think the presidential debate was on Monday Night Football and some other stuff. Let's move on to SmackDown, which was a much better show.
It was. SmackDown's doing much better at the minute, I think.
Yeah, I enjoyed it as well. Some great work from The Miz and Ziggler again.
Yeah, highlight of the night.
Easily the highlight of the night. And that's going to culminate at No Mercy.
Yes.
With an Intercontinental Championship match. Title versus career.
Yes. Do you think Dolph's going to end his career now, or do you think he's going to end up winning it?
I don't know.
Yeah, good answer. Yeah, same here. I don't want to see Dolph go because he's finally getting shown that he can talk on the mic really well and just puts on lots of matches. So maybe he's finally assigned to be on the main event. So it'd be weird if he suddenly disappeared out of nowhere. I don't know. Hard to say.
It is really hard to say. It's difficult.
Yeah. You know, maybe he'll get kayfabe fired and just turn up and attack the Miz the next night or something. Kind of like how John Cena did when he got fired from Nexus.
Or he'll kayfabe quit and go to Raw.
Well, he did mention that. He said, oh, this isn't like you'll turn up next night in Raw or NXT or whatever. This is it. You'll walk out of WWE forever. That's something Miz said.
Well, he might not have a TNA to go to, but I'm going to talk about that in a bit.
Oh, God, yeah. What TNA?
Yeah, that was excellent. What else happened on SmackDown this week?
8-man tag match, because SmackDown, so of course it was. It was American Alpha with Rhino and Slater versus the Ascension and the Usos, who had new music.
Yes.
Which we called.
Yes, they had new music, and they look more gangster now.
Yeah, they're gangsters now, yeah.
Yeah, they've got baseball caps and bandanas hanging out of their trousers, so they're gangsters now.
Yeah. Yeah, that was a good match. Usos ended up winning with the Tequila Sunrise.
Which Moro called as well. He called it the Tequila Sunrise.
Yeah.
Which I love that he called it that, because that's what it's called.
It was a good, I like the move as well.
Yeah, I really like that move. Made famous by Conan in WCW.
Yeah.
There you go.
That, you know, the one.
Sure.
But yeah, there's also an interesting slash weird thing with Randy and Bray. Like backstage things.
It was sort of like a recurring thing throughout the show. That Randy Orton kicked off the show.
Yeah.
And Bray interrupted in his mystery room, of course. And sent Randy Orton on basically a hunt. So this is like SummerSlam 94 when Leslie Nielsen was doing the hunt for the fake Undertaker.
Yeah.
Basically the same sort of thing.
Pretty much. Yeah, that was weird.
It was weird. It, you know, it ended in Randy Orton finding Bray Wyatt in his mystery room, putting the mask on, and I'm pretty certain that last bit was cocked up.
You think so?
Yeah, I do think so. I mean, it was weird because the video kept rewinding and then the voice kept getting deeper, which made me think it was intentional.
Mm.
And then it cut to that video of Bray talking over the top of this weird audio.
Oh, yeah.
Like, well, no. This weird audio was playing and Bray was, that video of Bray rocking back and forth, like, and it looked like he was talking. So it looked like they just cocked it up, and then they cut back to the commentary booth and they were all like, oh man, this is so weird. What's going on? What's going to happen? Oh. So I don't know if it was messed up or, yeah, or what. I couldn't understand.
Yeah, a bit of a weird one. For sure. What else happened? Becky got attacked by Alexa Bliss during her entrance. That's the thing.
I like that feud.
Yeah, I do.
I'm looking forward to that match at No Mercy as well.
Yeah.
I fully expect Becky to retain, but it's nice to see Alexa Bliss getting the kind of spotlight that I definitely feel she deserves. And yeah, she was pigtailed up again this week. So that's. I feel like we should both get bonus points just for that.
Yeah. Basically bonus.
Bonus points.
Kurt Hawkins had another one of his things, little package.
What do you make of these Kurt Hawkins vignettes?
They're all right. They're quite funny.
They are quite funny. I like when he puts his head between his legs and says, yeah. I think that's funny. He's got a major announcement next week. I hope we finally get to see him. I mean, the perfect time to bring him in was the other week when somebody needed a mystery partner and it was ended up being The Miz instead. That would have been the perfect time to bring him in.
Yeah.
I like Kurt Hawkins. I'm excited to see him.
Yeah, that'd be good, I think. Good stuff. And yeah, the main event, of course, was a WWE title. Dean versus AJ. With Cena on commentary. And yeah, good match.
Yeah, it was a good match. Before we go into that, there was a women's match as well. Nikki.
Yeah, exactly match, yeah.
And Naomi against Natalia and Carmella. And Carmella got another pinfall victory over Nikki.
Yes.
But the most important thing that we need to take away from this tag team match was, of course, that the bum wiggle was in this week.
Oh, yes. The bum wiggle has returned.
The bum wiggle has returned. And it's just... it's glorious.
You're a big fan of the bum wiggle.
Yeah, I'm like, that's my favourite thing in wrestling.
The best thing, best part of the night, the bum wiggle.
It's the best part of the week of wrestling. So Clash of Champions, Raw and SmackDown, that was the best bit.
Fair enough.
I've just got a lot of time for it.
Yeah, I mean, nothing against the bum wiggle, don't get me wrong.
It's been my favourite thing in wrestling for like a lot of years now.
Fair play.
Then the main event.
Yeah, it's like I was talking that. You interrupted me to talk about the bum wiggle.
Yeah, I did. I literally interrupted the main event stuff for that. That was my main event.
Good stuff. So Dean versus AJ. Great match. AJ like attacked Tina during the match, and then Tina distracted like Ambrose or something. But the referee said couldn't count the pinfall over AJ.
Mm-hmm.
And then Dean attacked Tina. And then AJ rolled him up and got the win.
Mm-hmm.
Grabbing the tights with jeans. Whatever he wears. And after the match, Cena attacked him both with AAs. And I set you up nicely for... No mercy. Yeah.
Stood there with the championship.
Yeah.
I don't think AJ's going to lose it this soon.
Nope,
I don't think Cena wins it just yet.
Not yet.
I do think he will. I'm telling you, that title reign is happening.
Yeah, it will.
But I don't think he wins it, not just yet.
No, I agree.
Cena was actually better on commentary than JBL and David Otunga combined.
Yeah, I agree. I 100% agree.
Maybe you should do that instead.
Yeah. Maybe when it's done with wrestling, he can do that.
Yeah, sure. I'd be happy with that.
Yeah.
He's good.
He is. Do you think there's a possibility that Cena could turn heel during his quest to get the 16th title reign?
I don't know anymore. I really don't. I mean...
It'd be a good story. He keeps coming so close to getting the title... He starts getting desperate to get the 16th title reign just to tie with Ric Flair, and he starts doing like more heelish things, like the slow build up. That could be cool, right?
Oh yeah, I mean, I 100% think that should happen.
Yeah,
but I 100% thought that should have happened
ages ago.
Yeah. So whether it happens now or not, I don't know. It's the interfering with the match and that sort of thing was quite Healy this week.
Yeah. It's a better tag team person, so.
I think what's going to happen is AJ's going to move on from No Mercy, and Cena and Dean Ambrose are going to have a feud instead.
Might be interesting.
Because they're the ones that seem to have more of the problem with each other in this feud than AJ and any of them. I know AJ's sort of, you know, beefing with Cena and whatnot, but it's Dean Ambrose and Cena that seems to have the more heat with each other.
True.
So I think AJ will move on to somebody else after No Mercy, and then Cena and Dean Ambrose will have a feud for a little while.
Good prediction. Yeah, I like it. Who do you think he moves on to, AJ? Who's next for the title?
That I don't know. Yeah. To be honest, I would quite like to see The Miz go for the championship.
That'd be interesting.
Maybe move into that slot.
So if Dolph ends up winning, he can move up to
many. Yeah, I mean, AJ is a is a heel, but he's not. I don't know.
Yeah,
I don't know. It's the simple answer. I don't know.
Yeah, it could be Randy Orton. He's, you know, still there.
Could be Randy Orton.
Bray Wyatt, maybe. Oh no, he's heel.
It depends. It's I don't know. Wait for No Mercy. See what happens then.
Yeah.
If Randy Orton comes through Bray Wyatt with a victory,
which he probably will,
and AJ Styles does win, like I think he does, then yeah, that's probably seems to be the logical step going forward. As long as AJ comes out winning, I don't care.
AJ needs
to hold that belt for a certain amount of, for a decent amount of time. You can't just lose it to, you know, a WWE.
John Cena.
Yeah, you know, a John Cena or a Randy Orton. I think he needs to take the belt and really sort of make it his own for a little while.
Yeah.
Because he's having a seriously good run at the minute.
Yeah.
And I think WWE see that. And I think they just need to capitalize on it and keep going and keep going and keep going with it.
Yep. Mike, would you agree?
AJ Styles has got main event of WrestleMania written all over him next year.
Yeah, seriously. He sent it to that jet.
Yes. So that was the week in WWE. Now, I want to talk about TNA.
Okay.
The rumor is that TNA can't afford to run Bound for Glory, which is supposed to be this coming Sunday.
Oh, dear.
You know, the build-up is in place. The final TNA Impact before Bound for Glory airs tonight, which is Road for Glory. Mm-hmm. TNA need to find funding for that event before Friday, otherwise it's not going to happen.
Yeah.
So, you know, by the time you hear this podcast, there's going to be some sort of announcement, whether it's somebody's bought TNA and the pay-per-view is going to go ahead, or, which is only rumor, so take this with a pinch of salt, that WWE have purchased TNA and TNA is done for.
Yeah, seriously.
See, what the idea is, if this is, you know, only from stuff that I've read, Wrestling Observer, I think, or PW Insider reported this, that WWE would be looking to purchase TNA for its video library and maybe some of its talent. Mm. But TNA as a company would be no more. They wouldn't do anything special with it. They'd probably just announce that they've acquired it and its video library and, you know, they'll be on the WWE Network or whatever.
Yeah, that'd be interesting. We have most of their big stars that came out of TNA and now we're in NXT, now in WWE.
So. And they'd be able to reference it as well.
Yeah, yeah. It's true.
Like Samoa Joe, he wouldn't have just been wrestling on the indies for a little while. He would have been, you know, in NXT, in TNA. And same with Austin Aries and AJ Styles and stuff like that. So, and even TJ Perkins.
Yeah.
What do you make of this? I mean, it's not a guarantee that WWE is going to pick it up. They, you know, Billy Corgan, I know, of the Smashing Pumpkins, wanted to put a deal in place to purchase the company, and from what I've read, he wants to rebrand the company completely and take it in a maybe a different direction, which would be very interesting because Billy Corgan is a big wrestling guy. Mm. And I've got a lot of time for that. If he's gonna take TNA and move it forward and make it seriously compete, then I have no problem with it. Because it can't keep going the way that it is. I watched Impact last week and I really enjoyed it. The wrestling aspect of it, at least.
Cool.
The Hardy stuff, I could really do without. But as a wrestling show, I thought it was great. The Grand Championship stuff is very interesting. It's a very interesting concept. And I don't really want it to be all for nothing.
Yeah.
Like, I mean, Cody Rhodes is just signed to TNA.
That's true.
He may not even get a debut.
Yeah, he won't even get there.
Like Damian Sandow, who is now Aaron Rex, is in TNA. He's only just got there. And he's in the final of this Grand Championship tournament. I don't. I'd feel bad for these guys.
Yeah, it'd be bad if he like wins the tournament and just like just gets fired.
He may not even. He may not even get the final because
yeah, that's true.
If WWE buy that company, then TNA is done. Yeah. There won't be a Bound for Glory.
It's true. And then where do they go from there?
Well, the company will be nothing. It'll just be folded. Yeah. WWE will own the video library. It'll own the talent.
They won't use them. Hey, we got you. Hey, Cody, we got you back again. Welcome back.
Yeah. it's very interesting. It's a very interesting time because either Bound for Glory is going to happen or it's not. And either WWE is going to own TNA or it's not.
TNA is on its last legs either way, I think.
Something needs to change. Something's got to give with TNA because it can't. It just can't.
It's been floundering around for a long while.
This business model is just not sustainable. It's Dixie not. Carter needs to get rid of TNA and needs to get rid of TNA this week to even fund Bound for Glory and the next set of TV tapings.
Yeah.
Because this is at the minute it's a laughing stock. And it's a real shame because there's talent on there and there's the potential for it to be a really good show.
Yeah.
But it's just marred in poor business strategy.
Pretty much, yeah.
And poor business decisions, rather. I, from a selfish standpoint, would like to see WWE acquire it just so that we can have the video library on the WWE network because some of that old TNA stuff is superb.
Yeah, it's great back in the day.
Some of the old X Division matches and some of the old pay-per-views are just superb.
Yeah.
But at the same time, I would quite like it to keep going because that's the only realistic competition for WWE. Ring of Honor, of course, it's its own thing. It's never going to be seen as realistic competition for the big boys.
Yeah, just more indie stuff, isn't it?
WWE is the gold standard in... It may not be product-wise, but of course, it's an absolute behemoth in sports entertainment, professional wrestling, whatever you want to call it.
Yeah.
If Billy Corgan's going to do it, he needs to do it quickly and... It'd be awesome if he's going to rebrand it and make it something completely different.
That'd be cool.
Ditch the six-sided ring, just have a standard wrestling ring again.
Yeah, definitely. I've never been a big fan of the big six-sided ring.
It was fine when it first came in. I thought it was unique and cool and different.
Yeah.
But that's when TNA was new and refreshing and different.
Yeah, that's when TNA was new and cool and refreshing.
Something's got to give.
Yeah.
And something's got to give very quickly. It's Wednesday now. Friday is quickly approaching, so we're gonna know. Well, and we'll talk about it more next week because there will be some kind of outcome. I was sort of looking forward to Bound for Glory as well after last week's Impact. I planned on watching it. I'm still going to watch Impact tomorrow. And if Bound for Glory happens, I'll watch Bound for Glory, and we'll talk about it more next week. But it's interesting times for professional wrestling.
It is
/ sports entertainment.
Yes, interesting indeed.
Yeah.
I think that's about it.
I think that's enough talking this week.
Good luck, TNA.
Yeah. This has been episode 32 of the Sonny and Finn Show.
It has.
Go subscribe to our podcast on iTunes, or you can find us on any other podcast service on any device that you may use anywhere.
Anywhere.
Go subscribe to our YouTube channel, Sonny and Finn Play.
Yep, yep.
Go follow us on Instagram, at SonnyFinnPC. Same on Twitter. Don't bother on Facebook, because we're not really using it.
Yeah, it's garbage.
It's garbage, and we're not using it. So, RIP Facebook.
Yeah.
But yeah, that's pretty much it. This has been episode 31. Thank you. 32.
That's the one.
Oh, and before we go... you'll notice that I said at the beginning of the podcast that we're being filmed and that this is going to be, you can see us and all this sort of stuff. And now you'll notice that you're just looking at the thumbnail. That's because the camera cut off halfway through. Next week, we'll film it and you'll get to see us in all of our glory looking wonderful because we know it's going to happen.
Yeah, seriously.
But for now, like I said, this is episode 32 of the Sonny and Finn Show. I'm Sonny.
I'm Finn.
And we will speak to you next time. Thank you very much, guys. Goodbye.
Thank you much. Goodbye.